Hello everyone, welcome back to On the Fly. Today we're taking a look at part 13 of our Sweeping the Seattle series, the topic being the LA Kings. The Kings finished the regular season with a 21-28-7 record, placing them 6th in the West Division. Overall, this is a team that is in the midst of a rebuild after their cup dynasties in the 2010 decade. This team will also be looking to rebuild overall with and trying to preserve their leadership core, like players like Drew Doughty, Jonathan Quick, as well as Anze Kopitar. This will be their draft strategy as well, to try and protect their young guys, as well as your veteran leadership core, like I mentioned before. And this is a team that can come back in the next few years and be an emerging force, and maybe, just maybe, come back and be the cup-contending team that they once were. Now that we know about the team, let's look at the players. Starting with the forwards. Anze Kopitar, Dustin Brown, Victor Arvidsson, Alex Iafallo, Adrian Kempe, Brandon Lemieux, Austin Wagner, Blake Lazzotte and Carl Grunschen were all the players to meet the two-forward exposed requirement. Andreas Athanasiou, Elias Anderson, Trevor Moore, Boko Imama, Michael Essaimon, and Matt Luff are all RFAs. And Martin Furk did not meet the games played requirement. Moving on to the defense, Drew Doughty has a non-movement clause. Ole Mattis, Sean Walker, Curtis McDermott, and Matt Roy are all the defense to meet the 1D exposed requirement. As Kale Klog, Austin Strand, and Jacob Mulverer, they're all RFAs, and Christian Rolandin did not meet the games played requirement. And then Jonathan Quick and Kyle Pettersson are the goalies, both of which do meet the one goalie exposed requirements. Now it's time to protect the players. Let's start with the forwards. Anze Kopitar is a clear pick. He is their captain, and because of this, he will most likely be protected, as well as newly acquired Victor Arvidsson from Nashville. As I said in previous episodes, it doesn't make sense to go after a guy unless you're going to protect him, so therefore he will be protected. As well as Alex Iafallo, not much surprise there. He's one of their best players, and he'll continue to do so. As well as Adrian Kempe and Brandon Lemieux. Both these players, of course, are key assets to their team and will continue to be. The reason I don't protect Dustin Brown here is because of his contract. He is paid way too much. It doesn't make sense for Seattle to pick him in the first place. Although they might take a crack at him if they really want to take the risk. Of course, they're not going to be pressed against the cap in any way. So if they want to take a big contract guy like Dustin Brown, they definitely could. Which is one of the reasons why I'm keeping Anze Kopitar. Because Kopitar, unlike Brown, Kopitar possesses that leadership that is required for a team as he's their captain. So that's why I'm protecting Kopitar and not Brown. Moving on, Carl Grunstrom, I believe, as well as Elias Anderson. Like I said in the early preview, the whole point of this for the Kings is to protect all their young guys as well as your leadership core. Kopitar is kind of their leadership guy, and all the rest of them are young guys. So with that, we'll move on to the defense. Drew Doughty, non-movement clause, still be protected if he wants to waive it, as well as Kyle Clegg and Sean Walker. Not much surprise here. Both these guys are the future of the team. Clay is up-and-coming prospect, as well as Walker. So those guys will both be protected. And then for the goalies, I'm protecting Pettersson here because, unlike Quick, Pettersson's still young, on a good contract. So it doesn't make sense for Seattle to pick Quick. So I think it'd make more sense for Seattle to pick Pettersson, which is why the LA Kings will protect Cal Pettersson. Now it's Seattle's turn. I believe the three most important players the Kraken will take a look at will be Dustin Brown, Matt Roy, and Jonathan Quick. For the leadership guys like Brown and Quick, I believe they'll definitely take a good look at them. They do provide that championship pedigree. They've all been there. They've all done it. Although the one issue with those two guys, as I said before, was that their contracts are way too much. And it doesn't make sense for the Kraken to take a risk when there's better players like Matt Roy, who is a young guy. He does have potential, could be a good stud for them, but he's kind of that low risk, low reward. He'll start in the AHL, but I do believe that Matt Roy will be the selection here. For me, Quick and Brown, just the contracts don't make sense. Knowing Ron Francis not going after very big contracts in the past with Carolina, I do believe that Matt Roy will be the selection. So with that, Matt Roy will be Seattle's 6th defenseman. If you made it this far in the video, thanks for watching. If you liked it, drop a like. If you liked it, consider subscribing. Tell all your friends about it. And leave a comment down below if you agree or disagree with me. Until next time, see ya!